Hey, welcome back, Warriors. This week we found a piece on Facebook Marketplace that we picked up for free. It's in pretty good shape, but it's a simple piece. It was manufactured in April of 2014, so it's not very old. And it is made of MDF. And we are going to get started on it.
Okay, so the first step is going to be to clean this piece with LA's Totally Awesome. And again, we get this at the Dollar Tree for $1.25. This piece is made of MDF. I found a label on the back. It is like a, you know, IKEA solder like type piece that was put together. So all of this is MDF. So we have to be very careful in the cleaning not to get the wood too wet, because water is not MDF's friend. Need to be worked on. I think they just need to be tightened. So I just want to make sure they're completely in. Okay, so these don't have their plugs anymore, so I'm going to use this epoxy putty stick by Mohawk to fill these in. You're going to cut off a square about that big, and then you're going to knead it like caramel. So it's all one color. Hardens really quickly. I'll be able to sand it flat and then go right to painting. Okay, I'm just going to scuff sand this top because it's kind of pitted all over the place. So because this is an MDF, I don't want to take too much off. So I got a 240 sandpaper in on Walt here. I'm gonna let this filler dry, and then I'll sand that smooth, and then we'll be on to painting. Okay, so these are dry now. I'm gonna use that same 240 sandpaper, because I don't want to go through this too badly, just to even these out. Thank you. Now I'm gonna prep it with the Rethunk Junk by Laura. Prep, I just put it in a small spray bottle because it makes life easier. Because this is MDF, there's a good chance that it's gonna bleed. So I'm gonna go ahead and prime it before I paint it with this Kilz Restoration primer. Can't even see the label anymore, huh? I'm gonna sand. I'm just gonna sand this smooth, get all the like little caps off. And this is a 320, a well used 320 sandpaper wrapped around a sanding block. So we're using the Rethunk Junk by Laura, and this is the Morning Mist. I'm not sure what the label, but a lot of paint in there. using the Rethunked by Laura to do some stripes, and this color is called True Gray. Okay, so we're going to do a second coat on these little knobs and the pearl. So I had this box and I put some duct tape on it to kind of stiffen it a little, and then just poked holes and put the screws underneath and attached them so it holds the hardware. And the reason I put it like this is because I want a little space in between each knob to paint. And you put your hand in the box and you twist to get all the edges. Back and forth, you can kind of hold it in place. Thank you.
Well, we're almost there. All we need to do is finish putting on the hardware, and we'll take it inside, and we'll stage it, show you guys what we have. But let's start with a little reminder of what we began with. We go. So time to move on to the next piece. Let us know what you think in the comments. We appreciate all of you subscribing and liking, and especially the comments. We enjoy reading them and responding to them. So as always, have a flippin' awesome day.